morning of day two. We're back in Asperger campsite, which is where we were last year. And I made some joke about being close to the Arctic Circle. And it's absolutely Baltic today. So cold. But we're going to start doing some work. I thought I'd hit you with a bit of science this morning on day three. It is cloudy. It's a little bit chilly, but it's not raining. And what are we actually doing here in Iceland? So I'm standing in Asperger Canyon, which is in the northeast of Iceland. It's about 70 metres high at this point. It's a big horseshoe-shaped canyon. And one of the things I'm trying to do for my PhD is work out how much rock was eroded from Asperger. It's just quite easy. We carried out a topographic survey last summer of the rim and the floor and stuff, but we don't actually know how deep the sediment is, because the floor of Asperger is full of sediment. So what we're doing is using a geophysical survey technique called electrical resistivity tomography, which involves placing electrodes like this every 5 meters along the sediment floor. As you can see, it kind of extends all the way up to that field. It's about 125 meters long, this transect. It puts electrical current into the surface and uses the electrodes to measure the difference in current and resistivity, and therefore we can get a picture of the subsurface. So we're trying to work out how deep the sediment is. One of the annoying things is it takes about 20 minutes per survey, which is kind of lucky in this field site, because got some swings to play on. So that's what I'm going to do for the next 10 minutes until it's finished running. All right, see you in a couple of days. Okay, so it's now the evening of day three, and we're, as you can see from the weather, it's blue sky. It's the first time the sun's come out in the entire 3-4 days that we've been here, and it's dinner time. Look what we're making: peas, onion, and ham, and we've got some couscous in here. There you go. It's 6 o'clock in the morning on day five, and I'm really not looking forward to field work today. The wind is howling through my tent. I can hear the rain bouncing off the top, and all I want to do is just stay stuck in my warm, dry sleeping bag. But we've got to go to Detafoss, which is Europe's most powerful waterfall, so that should be fun. Let's hope we don't get soaked, and I hope my tent's still here by the time we come home. Today is day 8, and it's our last full day in Asperger, which is a little bit sad because I kind of quite like it here. We've pretty much done everything we came to do, which is lots of resistivity surveys, measure some boulders, do some surveying of some terraces down further upstream from here. So today we're just doing a little bit more survey, just to fill in the gaps of the transects that we did earlier on in the week. And as you can see, the weather is absolutely glorious today. It makes a change from the 3 degrees that we had 2 days ago. I've even put some sun cream on. So, yeah. Oh, anyway, it's looking like a beautiful day.
laugh politely at repeats. Yeah, kiss me when my lips are thin. 'Cause holy cow,
I was doing 10 days of PhD work, then I spent 10 days teaching on an undergraduate fourth year trip, which is now over. I'm now driving back from the airport after dropping them off for another 7 days of field work. And I'm going to introduce you my two field assistants for the week. We have Andrew, the General.
Hey.
And we have Slasher, Mr. Alex Ingle, who is... He's also coming along to make a little video about my research, a little mini documentary, because he's now got an excellent filmmaking company, and he's already got the camera equipment ready. So, Video Diary's back up and running. That glacier is Solheimer Jökull, and what we're trying to do today is access these gorges around here and over the side of that, basically over the top of that ridge. So we've just walked up, you probably can't see the car, it's all the way down there, walked up here planning to walk along this ridge which Andrew is standing on, and then walk up onto this ridge over here and up over the top. However, bit of a minor balls up, to be honest. Didn't check the map contours. We've got a 50 meter drop. So we're gonna have to rethink our access route a little bit, because had a bit of a shocker, to be honest. Hopefully we'll be all right. Evening, welcome to our accommodation for this week. We actually ended up in a schoolhouse which is closed, which is a little bit strange and creepy because we've got loads of kids' toys everywhere, including little seats which are perfect size for Alex. Just going to give you a little tour. So that's the place we're staying in. Andrew sleeping in this room. Come through this door. This is the just the shower toilet. You can't really see it. Here we go, Alex attempting to film the weather.
A little dog just came in here.
Oh, what a bastard.
Yeah, he let him, just locks him back out.
And basically, while this place is pretty creepy, it's a lot better than the alternative, which would be camping. Mm. And, Oh, the door's locked. Oh. Look at this. Proper bleak. I'm coming back inside. That is grim. This is horrendous weather. So today we managed to find our way in, involving walking up this cliff up here, up the flank. But yeah, so I've had a good day of field work, and we've actually managed to get everything done that I was planning to do, which is lucky. So this is therefore now my last day of field work during my PhD. So this is probably the last bit of video diary. It's time for a beer.